Hey everyone, welcome back to Apocalypse Movies. Jake Berlin here, and this is my 2019 top five list for the year so far. We're doing a series of these, and you're gonna see these from each of us here at Apocalypse. And this is a video gonna be taking my top five, and I'm excited to talk about it. We got some interesting choices here, a lot of good movies so far. I had a very difficult time doing this one, but I think I'm confident in my list and comfortable with it, and so without further ado, here we go. Coming in at number five on my list, I have the romantic comedy, one of the best romantic comedies I've seen in the last couple years, Long Shot. This movie stars Charlize Theron and Seth Rogen, and I absolutely adore this movie. The reason it's not on any other lists here at Apocalypse, because they just didn't get a chance to see it. I did. I thought it was incredible. Romantic comedies is, they're very hard to do these days, and Netflix does them very well, but that seems to be like the only company that does. But what Jonathan Levine did with this movie and what Seth Rogen and Charlize Theron were going to be able to do on screen together, it was very rare and, you know, just kind of like catching lightning in a bottle almost. The story was really good. The characters were very fleshed out. And the chemistry between the two leads was very believable. And it was funny. It was romantic. It had some good drama in there as well. And that's what you kind of need for that kind of formula, and it's very, very successful in my opinion. So, number five so far in 2019 is Long Shot. Number four on my list is the most recent film I have seen, and that is Spider-Man Far From Home. Now, many of you can argue that, yes, this movie is not in the first 6 months of the year, but it's right on that cusp, and it's the most recent film that we saw, which is why we included it on this list. But look, the movie in general, I was very much looking forward to this movie. I thought there was a lot of cool things going for it. It was the movie that followed Endgame, which had some big, big, you know, just weight on its shoulders. And it just knocked it out of the ballpark. There are so many cool things to love about this movie. Not just as far as the action, which is absolutely incredible. But, you know, the chemistry and the relationship between Peter Parker and MJ by Zendaya and Tom Holland. Absolutely remarkable what those two did on screen together. You have Jake Gyllenhaal as Mysterio, which was, he just kills everything. He's my favorite actor working right now, so anything he does, I'm locked into. And then everything as far as the MCU goes, all the connections and everything, very, very cool the way they tied in previous films and the story that happened, you know, before all of this with Endgame and Infinity War. And also, there's some really cool things going forward. And so, overall, this movie, you know, in all facets is a total home run. I really enjoyed it. I can't wait to go see it again, but it is number four on my list. Not to say that it can't be one, two, or three. It just locks in at number four for me. Number three on my top five list for 2019 so far may come to a big surprise for many. That is Toy Story 4. Now, I grew up with the Toy Story franchise, so quite honestly, I may be biased in this franchise. I don't know. Every movie they seem to make just seems to be incredible in every way possible. What they're able to do with the characters, how they're able to create a new story that still brings the fun, but also the kind of dramatic emotion involved in it. I think it's something that's very rare in film these days. This franchise has been going on for 24 plus years, or you know, however long it was. Yeah, I think the first one came out in 95. And so it's very rare for something to do that. And yes, some people can agree that the third one should have been the final movie, but I do believe that this is a great ending to this franchise, if it is in fact the ending of this franchise. And so Toy Story 4, total home run for me. You know, what Woody did, what Bo Peep did, the story with Buzz and other friends, you know, Gabby, all these type of characters, how they're able to kind of bring them all together is absolutely fascinating and very rare in film. And so there's no way that it can't land on my 2019 top five list of the year so far. Number two on my list for the year so far is How to Train Your Dragon, The Hidden World. I love this movie. I love this franchise, but I love this movie. It's very rare to find a franchise that has a third film that is just as good or better than its first film. This one is very special. It does some really incredible things. But the biggest thing that they're able to do is tell a story within an allotted time that is perfectly planned out. It is not overly long, it is not too short. Everything is there for a reason. It also has a little bit of personal connection for me. I see very big similarities between Hiccup and Toothless and myself and my dog. It's very, very similar and heartfelt. And so I connect with it a little bit stronger than others possibly. But just the character evolution with certain characters, the relationships that are involved as the kids grow older, the world that was built and how it finished, There's very few franchises that are able to start something this big but end it so perfectly with such a tight knot, and so I can't give enough credit to everyone involved. I'm sad to see the franchise go, but I do believe that it ended perfectly, which is why it ranks in at number two on my list. Number one, none other than Avengers Endgame. It's obvious at this point, all of us are gonna have it at this best movie of the year so far. It is by a wide margin in many of our opinions. This movie has it all. It surpassed expectations in every way possible. We thought we knew what was gonna happen, and it threw two dozen curveballs our way and went in a completely different direction. And it's absolutely amazing what Joe and Anthony Russo are able to do with this franchise and these characters, you know, telling a story that is so far set apart from everything else, but so much involved in everything else. It's hard to follow up something like Infinity War and how massive that movie was, but they did it and they doubled down and successfully just crushed it. And so, you know, the stories with Tony and Cap and just how that ended and how perfect it was, it just felt right in so many ways possible. And so Avengers Endgame, you know, I totally respect if you don't have it at number one, but for me, it's by a wide margin, and I would be surprised if it doesn't hit that second or third spot by the end of the year, just because of the magnitude of it and how special it is to have a 22nd film in a franchise be this massive and how important it is. And so the MCU is gonna keep going for a very long time, but we will never see something else like Avengers Endgame ever again as far as footage and, you know, anticipation and box office. It is a rare film. And so for that reason, among many others, it is number one on my list for this year so far. Well, there you guys go. There is my list for 2019 so far. A lot of good movies came out this year, but those are my five. I have Longshot, I have Spider-Man Far From Home, Toy Story 4, How to Train Your Dragon in the Hidden World, and Avengers Endgame. A great list, but like I said, many great films have come out this year, and I can't wait to see what the rest of 2019 have. I know we're gonna be very excited to get to our top 10 list at the end of the year, because there's gonna be a lot of mashups and a lot of shakeups, and so I'm very excited. But for now, comment down below, let me know what you think of my list. Let me know what you think your list is and what movies you like more. A couple honorable mentions, you know, I had Aladdin in there as well. John Wick 3, obviously can't miss out on that one. Booksmart, you know, Fighting With My Family is in there as well. So a couple good movies that missed the list just by that much. But for now, there's my list. I am Jake Blinn. Make sure you hit that like, share, subscribe. Check us out on iTunes and Instagram. As always, of course, this YouTube channel. Can't thank you guys enough for joining me. Until next time, see you guys later.
Hey everyone, Jacob Bartley here. Thanks for watching. If you want to check out something similar from Apocalypse Movies, click this video up here. If you want something a little bit different, check out this video down here. If you haven't done so, please subscribe to Apocalypse Movies and let us know your thoughts in the comments section. We always love to hear from you.